Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com. Is D'Angelo Russell on his way out of Los Angeles? The Lakers dropped game 3 to the Denver Nuggets in painful fashion. That game was right there for the taking, and the Lakers just could not reach out and grab it. They could not take the win away from the Denver Nuggets. And now there's a lot of questions about D'Angelo Russell, who was frankly awful in game 3. Dropped a total of 0 points. 0 for 7 shooting from the field, 0 for 6 from 3, 3 boards, 2 assists, 1 steal in just 24 minutes. Also had a stinker in game 1, was great in game 2, and was great during the regular season. But with D'Angelo Russell, the question has always been, can he produce in the playoffs? So far, that answer has been a resounding no. Brian Windhorst on the Hoop Collective said, as Lakers fans or NBA fans start to figure out what trade they're going to make this summer that's going to get them a third star, because that will begin. It already will begin because I think the series is cooked. Well, he's right. Let's just, as an aside here, we're already having those conversations about what comes next this summer. He said it's likely D'Angelo Russell is going to opt out of his contract. The Lakers gave him a 1 year with a player option. I would say it's likely he's going to opt out of that. And once he's a free agent, they can't really trade him. You could, in theory, do a sign and trade, but if the Lakers are in the apron, they can't receive a player in a sign and trade. So it's likely they're not going to be able to execute a sign and trade, even if there's a team that wants D'Angelo Russell and wants to trade the Lakers a star, which is a totally different conversation. So a lot of Lakers fans right now saying, get rid of D'Lo, get him off this team. I'm here to tell you, it's a very complicated situation for the Lakers. The root of the problem, it's the Lakers cap situation. Should D'Angelo Russell just no longer be on the team? You look next season, he has a player option for almost $19 million. If D'Angelo Russell does not pick up that player option, that doesn't mean the Lakers suddenly have $19 million to go spend. No, in fact, if D'Angelo Russell doesn't pick up his player option and he goes somewhere else in free agency, most likely the Lakers will not be able to replace him. The reason for that is because when we're adding up their cap sheet here, I'm over on SpotTrac right now taking a look at this, $178 million, almost $179 million in salaries committed to next season. And that's before we get into Max Christie, who's a restricted free agent. LeBron has a player option. Could he not pick up that option and then get a bigger deal with the Lakers? That's become something too. So you look at this in terms of the salary cap, they're way over the cap. So they're, even without D'Angelo Russell, they're not going to have cap space to go spend. They're, in fact, over the first apron as well, which could make it tricky, as Windhorst noted, to do a sign and trade. I know a lot of people immediately jump to, oh, well, just sign and trade the guy, and that way you'll get something for him. That's a very complicated situation to get into. In fact, right now, before the Lakers even fill out their roster, before they figure out what they're going to do with restricted free agent Max Christie, they're only $10 million below the second apron. There's a pretty good chance that if D'Angelo Russell does wind up staying, especially if he gets a new deal, they're going to be above the second apron. So him walking away, they're so far above the cap. Him walking away, maybe it gives you the ability to use your taxpayer mid-level exception. Maybe that's probably your best case. You're probably not going to have access to the full mid-level exception. So you're talking about maybe $5 million or so that you would have to go spend. Now, obviously, there's some decisions that are going to have to be factored in here. What happens with LeBron? That's the biggest one, right? LeBron says, I'm out. Okay, that changes the math on everything. Christian Wood, Jackson Hayes, Cam Reddish, they all have player options. Now, those are small contracts. They're not nearly as consequential as something like LeBron or D'Angelo Russell. But still, those are also decisions that are going to have to be made for the Lakers to figure out their cap situation. But again, the bottom line, the Lakers, this is why they had to explore trades for D'Angelo Russell at the trade deadline. We talked about it since last summer. Now the power is in D'Angelo Russell's court in that he can walk away and leave the Lakers with nothing. And because they're so far over the cap, assuming LeBron sticks around, they won't be able to take his salary and replace him. Now, all of that being said, the best case scenario for the Lakers, I believe, would be, and I think this is not likely, but the best case scenario for the Lakers would be D'Angelo Russell picks up that player option, would be this issue right now in the postseason is so pronounced that it scares away all suitors for him. And he decides, I'm going to bet on myself one more year. I'm going to pick up my player option. What that would do is that would give the Lakers the ability then to take that almost $19 million in salary and use it in a trade. Again, if he does not pick up his player option, which is pretty likely, he had a great season, he's probably going to want more of a long-term deal. If he doesn't pick up his player option, the Lakers can't trade him. Their only options at that point are either pray for the unlikely scenario where a sign and trade becomes available, sign him to a new deal, which I don't know if you want to commit long term, depends on what the number would be at for D'Angelo Russell. And you got to be really careful, because if we're of the mindset, which I'm seeing from a lot of Lakers fans, that D'Angelo Russell is not the guy you want long term, that this playoff series against Denver is the proof that he cannot be on the team long term, well, then you got to be really careful if you're going to keep him on a new contract, because you got to make sure it's a tradable contract and not one that becomes a negative value. So you got to be careful with that too. Or he's going to walk away and leave the Lakers with nothing. And because their cap situation, they can't really replace him. So again, I think the best result from the Lakers' perspective, not the likeliest result, would be he picks up that player option. That would then give the Lakers another opportunity to potentially trade him. Now, Darvin Ham believes D'Angelo Russell is going to bounce back in game four. That may not actually be the best thing for the Lakers. Again, if we're looking at this as though this series is done, and I think it probably is, then D'Angelo Russell having a big bounce back, let's say he goes on a heater and goes for 40 points and rehabs some of his value. Again, I think the best scenario for the Lakers would be he opts in and he's a $19 million expiring contract you can use on the trade front. That's probably the best case for the Lakers. So him going on a heater and maybe improving his value in free agency, while that would be the best thing for D'Angelo Russell, may not actually be the best thing for the Lakers at this point, strange as that may sound. So something to keep an eye on for game four for sure. But D'Angelo Russell, will he stick with the Lakers? You know, he seemed to be happy here in Los Angeles. He played great over the course of the season. He was very clearly the Lakers' third best player. But once again, here we are in a situation where his performance in the playoffs is going to overshadow everything that he did in the regular season. So this is one of the big questions of the summer for the Lakers. Number one, will D'Angelo Russell opt into his contract or not? He has until June 29th to decide on that. And then number two, what do the Lakers do from there? Do they offer him another contract? Do they move forward knowing that they can't really replace him? They're not going to have spending power to go find a player of his caliber on the market. Do they give him a new deal? Do they try to figure out a sign and trade? All of this is going to be one of the most important questions of the summer for the Lakers. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. What should the Lakers do in the D'Lo situation? Again, this is why they had to explore trades at the trade deadline. I'm not saying they should have made a trade. There wasn't much out there that made a lot of sense for the Lakers, but this is why they were looking at deals, despite the fact that D'Lo is playing well, because of the situation that they're now finding themselves in for the summer, whenever it is that the offseason does start, whether it officially kicks off on Saturday, tomorrow for game two or game four, or if it's extended another few days or not when the Lakers head back to Denver for game five. Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, stay safe and see you.